Dear students, let's study about bridge rectifier. About a bridge rectifier, we can write that this is a modified full wave rectifier which has several advantages over a common center tap rectifier. Center tap full wave rectifier we already studied in the previous sections. And in a center tap rectifier, we use two diodes for full wave rectification. And the basic difference between the two is in bridge rectifier, we can write it uses four diodes for its rectification mechanism. Let's discuss the basic circuit diagram of a bridge rectifier. In this diagram, you can see to the AC supply, we connect the primary coil of a step-down transformer and to the secondary coil. Without using a center tap, we connect its two terminal to a circuit which is made up of four diodes in a specified manner with a load resistance which is used for the rectification mechanism. And in this situation, say we talk about the positive half cycle of this input supply. Say if the terminals A and B of the secondary coil are positive and negative, here we can see that if terminal A is positive, diode D1 will be forward biased and D2 will be reverse biased because this N side will be connected to the positive terminal. So current will pass through D1, and again here D4 will be reverse biased because current is coming in this direction and it cannot pass from N side to P side. So current will flow through the load resistance from its terminal X to terminal Y. And on the other side, here we can see that the current will flow through diode D3 and it will pass through it. And it will reach the other terminal which is at negative polarity. So here we can write that D3 is forward biased again. So in this situation, the current is passing in this manner, the way I am drawing the arrows. And finally, from load resistance, we can say current is flowing from terminal X to terminal Y. And after this half cycle, when negative half cycle starts, the polarity of terminal is reversed. So terminal B is positive and now this terminal A is negative. In this situation, current will flow from terminal B. And if it is positive, we can see that diode D3 will be reverse biased because its N side is connected to positive terminal. So whatever current is coming, it will pass through D4 which is forward biased. Again D1 is reverse biased because current is coming onto the N side of diode D1. So again it will pass through the diode in the same direction and finally it will pass through D2 and reach the terminal A. So when it is positive, the other terminal is negative, current will flow in this manner through diode D4, again through load and again through D2 and finally reach to the terminal A. So here we can see in both half cycles, the current flowing through the load resistance is in same direction. That's why the output graph will be the same which we get in a center tap rectifier, or it can be written as a normal full wave rectified output. Here you can see that first half cycle is corresponding to the forward biasing of diode D1 and D3, and the second half cycle, which is corresponding to the negative half cycle of the input voltage, we can see it is corresponding to the forward biasing of diode D2 and D4. Again, the next half cycle is corresponding to diode D1 and D3 forward bias. So this is the manner we can say at every stage, two diodes are active in series, so the current capacity of diodes will increase because in a normal center tap rectifier, at a time only one diode is forward biased, so its current capacity must be high. as these two are in series at a time, either D1 and D3 or D4 and D2. So the current capacity of a bridge rectifier is certainly more than a normal center tap rectifier.